Hardly any day is as symbolically charged and paradoxical as the wedding day. Surrounded by rituals from the past and everyone they know, two people give each other the most intimate promise to be faithful forever in the future. However, with its traditional and religious roots as well as the demand for lifelong commitment, marriage seems almost like an antithesis to a modern society that highly values individuality and freedom. What does it say about our relationships when we don't trust them to last without a contract, and even with a contract they regularly fail? Is it perhaps time for us to abandon the concept of marriage, at least in its current form? Statements about marriage tend to sound like universal truths, but in fact, almost everything about marriage has varied greatly between cultures, eras, and social classes. From patriarchy to matriarchy, from the number and gender of the people involved to the societal expectations, whatever constellation of marriage you think of, you can be fairly certain that it has already existed. Especially in the past few centuries and decades, marriage has changed on an unprecedented scale. One of the most interesting of these changes is that up until the 18th century, marriage was never about love. Instead, it was a means to a strategic end used by the upper classes for political, social, and monetary gain, and by the lower classes for business alliances and family extensions. All these goals were far too important to be based on the volatile and irrational feelings of the couple that was to be married. Only with the Enlightenment did the idea emerge that partnership should serve the personal happiness of the couple. However, this focus on love and romance, which has made relationships so much more fulfilling, is the very reason why marriage as an institution has lost its stability and importance. Both marriage and the societal expectations associated with it have changed significantly in recent decades. The church has lost influence, and marriage is less of a social norm than it was 50 years ago. Depending on which statistics you look at, there seems to be a long-term decline in marriages, and the average age for people to get married has steadily gone up. There has also been a considerable rise in the number of divorces, yet at the same time, divorces are seen less as a moral or personal failure. Last but not least, the concept of marriage has changed in that same-sex couples are now in many countries allowed to marry as well, another indication of how comprehensively societal values and ideas can change within just a few generations. Although this development was met with an outcry in some parts of society, it might be merely the collapse of the last remaining pillar of traditional marriage. The other pillars, such as permanence, procreation, mandatory monogamy, and the adherence to traditional gender roles, have long lost their imperative nature. Despite all these changes, marriage is still a prevalent form of living, so everyone has to decide at some point whether he or she wants to take this path. There are many arguments in favor, from the romantic notion of marriage as the ultimate proof of lifelong commitment to more pragmatic reasons such as the multitude of tax and legal advantages. Especially in times of general volatility and uncertainty, marriage can be seen as a promise of greater security and stability. This might also be the reason why some studies find that married people live longer and happier lives, although it is important to add that most studies only provide averaged values and these findings are merely a matter of correlation, not causality. In a somewhat more abstract sense, marriage is also a way of keeping oneself from discarding long-term goals for short-term impulses. Since divorces are expensive, lengthy and painful, in the event of a marital dispute, one may be more willing to work on oneself and the relationship instead of breaking up. However, the concept of marriage often seems to work only to a limited extent, perhaps because a lifetime is now significantly longer than in the time from which the idea of lifelong commitment comes. According to official statistics, every second to third marriage ends in divorce. Who would get on an airplane with a comparable probability of crashing, even if the flight up to the crash is quite enjoyable? One may rightfully ask how many people get married merely due to the pressure to conform to societal norms. In addition, weddings are by now big events that can easily cost a five-figure sum, and many of the tax and legal advantages can be achieved even without marriage. And even this side has its romantic arguments. Shouldn't a good relationship be able to last without a contractual basis? After all, there is hardly a less romantic idea than that of a partner only staying in a relationship because he or she is contractually obliged to do so. What does all of this mean for the future of marriage? Well, marriage is not an immutable concept, so we can adapt it to our modern needs. We can already see the trend that fewer and fewer people in their 20s and 30s are entering into a lifelong marriage with joint children. The desire for a stable two-person relationship remains as high as ever, yet the expectations of such relationships are changing. It is no longer about having the longest possible relationship, but about having a high emotional and intimate quality during the time together. As a result, traditional marriage is either entered into later or discarded in favor of serial monogamy. This means that individuals repeatedly enter into medium-term exclusive relationships, which are eventually followed by a period of being single and then by the next relationship. Such relationships may or may not be marital and are increasingly lived in the form of living apart together or cohabitation. So perhaps in the future, relationships will be supported less and less by the institution of marriage, but will be entered into solely for their own sake, lasting only as long as both partners want to and feel emotionally fulfilled by it. If this leads to relationships falling apart more often, this isn't necessarily a bad thing. It can also be seen as a learning process through which both parties learn more about themselves, grow as human beings, and create a foundation for the next, better relationship. Of course, one may still choose to enter into marriage. Nevertheless, it remains to be said that marriage has now lost its monopoly on defining relationships and families. Couples can find each other regardless of gender or marital status and do not need the legitimacy of church or marriage, just as a family can exist wherever there are children. It is not likely that any singular type of relationship will soon achieve the status of normalcy that a traditional marriage long enjoyed. Instead, we are confronted with a pluralism of relationships and family types, all of them more voluntary, unstable and diverse than they used to be. Presumably then, the future of marriage depends on how well the concept can adapt to the new social values and realities that shape our postmodern world.